up to the north from the car park. Southwest there, and you can see there's black Norfolk Island pine, that's Black Island there, that's Esperance, that's Tyler Alley Bay, Woody Island in the middle of the bay, there's one of the boats go out. We're facing due west.
There's a big one out there.
This is the eastern or southeastern side of Frenchman. Stimulus package here at Hellfire Bay. There's the Frenchman's peak we just came from. Down at Hellfire Bay, you can do some serious beautiful now, the sun's out. Mary down the beach. up there too now. Like today, that's the track around. There was a walk, wasn't there? Thistle Cove. And this, I'm not sure whether the photograph was Polaroid sunglasses or not. The Polaroid filters. It's unreal. Great snorkeling spots around, and you could scramble over rocks for hours. Radiator overhaul. We might be spending another day or so here. That's where we were for lunch over there near Frenchman's Peak. And this morning I noticed a bit of coolant dripping on a injector that we popped in the Toyota. Here's the jetty at Esperance. We might even have time to walk out along. We might even go to the movies. And a bike. Drive up the Norseman tomorrow, a bit of luck. Pacific gull flying around here. Or kelp gull. There must be even the kelp here. back fence. Yeah, who's doing the washing? I'm catching up on the diary as the trains go by, checking up the log books and phoning Actuagle to book in our PV cells on the roof. Another truck. On Saturday morning we left 50k out of Esperance, left an hour or so ago. We're at Pioneer Park in Scadden, driving through lots of little lakes, 44k out of town though. The lakes started to become a bit dry, and it's dry farming country like this. But we had the sun out once. And it's all overcast, it'll be a nice cool drive. Follow this road up to Norseman. The walls of the loo were painted in the Temperance Hotel. Probably maybe that's where it was. This is a railway up to Norseman, 110 to go to Norseman, about 100. They've gone in the cattle. It's like they used to crop it, and now it's all grassland. Deviations on the road into the sidings to load the train.
We've actually caught up to a train. Actually, we've got a photo of a train doing this before, haven't we?
Just gone
same
past,
sort of train.
Lake Gilmore.
Just gone past Lake Gilmore.
Yeah, the train we took before is going up to
Widgeyville.
Is that
what it was?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, here you are.
This is the one that
this looks like it's
morning.
Going past the siding. Yeah, this will be the one that woke us this morning. Well, no, I don't know, because it won't have been stopping at all the spots, so I don't think that's right. There's the...
Went past
at
lunchtime.
Yeah. Ah. Yeah. Obviously an ore truck. And it's... Who knows what's all the ore.
We'll have to Google it.
Google.
Port van. Stop it.
Like a long ore train. Actually, they'll be sort of standard size, I suppose, because it's waiting in the siding for the other one to go past. So they can't be longer than the sidings. And the sidings were 2K, weren't they? Wasn't it 2K? They sit on the...
Dundas Rocks from the old coach road. Might be a bit wet, etc. That's the road up to Norseman. The old coach road went through Dundas, 1892. Drive north to Norseman another day, or south along the old coach road, and have a look at Lake Dundas and Dundas Rocks to the south. And 2K in. There's a lot of granite boulders just over there, back towards that little lake.
.net.au/rn/360. I'm Brent Clough, and I hope you can join me next week on 360 for more.
It's still 40 degrees and more over in the middle of New South Wales, and battling bushfires. We're in the low 20s over here. The cool breeze at Dundas Rock. Pile the rocks. The sun just came out for a moment. That's the weather back behind us. And we're just starting to see beside the road here why the Balladonia Road is still closed. Along the Eyre Highway, but it had a bit of rain. And lovely salmon gum territory. This is Fraser Range. Lakes, numerous dry lakes, it says. After rain, okay. One of those pleasant little camp spots. Minutes to five. Well, we camped at Afghan Rocks rest area, which is actually south of Afghan Rocks themselves. It was a year and 1 month to the day, 21st yesterday, that we actually camped at Afghan Rocks last year, and it was a bit more trees than this spot here. We didn't actually get a photo of the camp spot. There's a couple of guys who told us about Red Rocks Point east of Majura, which we'll have to check out next time. There's a few trees decorated like this across the Nullarbor. We've just passed the airstrip for the Flying Doctor back down there. We're coming up now the longest straight stretch of road. Oh, I've seen a few of these in the scrub. It's a survey mark for the highway. There are no camels anymore much down here. March flies. Oh, we're at Caiguna. 20 minutes ago we parked here. We had the spot to ourselves. It's a lovely cool day. A bit of a breeze and bushfires down the coast.
It's 50 k's from Majura.
50 to Cockabilly the other way.
50 to Cockabilly the other way.
Miles of beautiful casuarinas. blowing in the wind. Lots of new growth. Okay. Yeah, there's an acacia. Most of it's unfenced. You just drive off behind the roadside stops.
And we
haven't seen a stray animal at all.
No, we haven't seen any animals at all. Stray
last
or otherwise,
time,
haven't seen kangaroos or emus or anything. This is just coming up to the lookout at the top of Majura Pass. Drop down over the escarpment in a minute.
40 k's down to the ocean.
40 k's to the ocean. We're going down the escarpment in a minute. Here it comes.
Down onto the road plane.
not as spectacular as coming down.
That's probably the old road.
Here comes the, he wasn't very worried about it because he hasn't gone very fast.